The big question is what makes an independent film. It's a bit of a misnomer because we're all dependent. As a filmmaker, you're dependent on camera, on sound, on screenwriter and actors. But what we define independent cinema is no Hollywood money, no single source money, unless it comes from your mum. And these filmmakers who make the films that, like the ones we have at Raindance, these are all made of very small budgets. They're deeply, deeply passionate projects. And very often they would not make it through the so-called industry because of censorship or because they're considered too financially risky or the topics are too extreme to be palatable to the big guys in the film industry. That's what makes independent film so fantastic, is because these are very passionate personal stories that need to be told. And the ones that we have at Raindance, of the thousands that were submitted, not only are deeply passionate stories, but, God bless, they're entertaining. We had a record-breaking number of submissions, on nearly 8,000 submissions this year, as many as any festival in the world, nearly. We're showing 90 features, 85 shorts, 14 web experiences, and I think it is a dozen or two dozen music videos. Well, this year we have strands. The opening weekend is music and the China Day. The last weekend is the Raindance Lab VR arcade, virtual experience, reality, and the web fest. And in between, we have the LGBT strand, the women in film strand, we have the Mexican strand, we have the documentaries, we have the short films, we have the music videos, and we tend to cluster those together. So if you look at our website, raindancefestival.org, you should be able to click on and decide which one, two, three, or if you're a glutton, which 12 days you're going to attend. We have always resisted strands. We think a movie is movie, no matter who makes it, a woman or LGBT. But we've found over the years that we need to highlight that, because women have been terribly underused or underappreciated in the film industry. And some of our best films and some of my favorite films have been either written, produced, or directed by women. We have an amazing documentary lineup this year. We have documentaries on environment, on social change, on executions, good or bad in America. We've got a documentary, I could only watch the first 40 minutes, about what happens to people in Afghanistan when you see prisoners being prepared for execution. These are films that completely blow your mind. And then we have a wonderful British movie called Amsterdam, which is basically a caper, a kind of a lad's movie, coupled with a very gritty American black and white feature from the East Village, called After Adderall. Adderall, of course, the antidepressants that most Americans are hooked on. There's such a wide range of films. We try to make it very clear what's funny and what's scary and what's horrible and what's thrilling and so on, depending on your personal taste. We are very, very proud and excited to be working with Lexus, a very innovative brand. Also with Aeon, the Strand Palace Hotel, who help us accommodate all the visiting filmmakers. And of course, where we're standing today, Century Club, London's hidden secret. It's where all the delegates who have delegate passes can meet and network and schmooze the schmooze and walk the walk and talk the talk in between screenings, and our amazing lineup of 40 some odd events and panels and lectures and so on that we have in addition to the screenings. I keep getting asked by filmmakers how they should break in, and I have to keep reminding filmmakers that it is a people industry. It's not what you know, it's whom. So the advantage of attending a festival like Raindance is you have a like-minded bunch of people in a room as here today. And you don't have to say, what do you do? Oh, you're in banking. Oh, I don't want to talk to you. They're all interested in the same thing as you are. And of course, a lot of new people into the film industry really don't know how to network. So I always go up and say, hi, my name is, and this is what I do. What do you do? And get them talking to you. And I guess a secret tip of good networking is be quiet. Listen to what the other person has to say. And then they'll think you are a good listener. And then when you want them, they're more ready to listen to you. At Raindance, we have about 40 different panels on all different topics, from co-productions to new money to the effect of virtual reality, story pitching and so on. Also parties. And the Raindance ecosystem includes hubs in Berlin, Brussels, Budapest, Paris, Barcelona, Beijing, New York, Los Angeles, Montreal, Vancouver, and Toronto. And each of those cities, you see, once you join Raindance, you can start talking to people in all these different cities. And we've got filmmakers on our MA program, for example, who a director living in Ecuador working with a screenwriter in San Francisco and a producer in Toronto. They shot something that's being edited in Berlin by another MA student. So the whole... way you make it now in film, or I should say the creative industries, is by working and networking with people online all over the world. What's good about things like the festival, you get to actually touch the flesh and see what they're really like rather than looking at that image on Skype or Google Hangout. Well, it first started, I had £150 left over. I got a variety product guide from Cannes that year. I didn't know anything about movies. I love movies. And I circled about 75 of these films I thought would look pretty cool. And I had 150 quid. I was sharing an office, had a fax machine that cost £1 of fax. So I dropped a press release and faxed it out until my money ran out. And they showed up. That was the year we had What's Eating Gilbert Grape with Johnny Depp and Leonardo DiCaprio. And the festival's just risen. Every year it's gone up. This year we're blessed with partnering with Aeon and, of course, Lexus, who's letting us do the VR arcade. Lexus is a brand like us who are a challenger brand. They're also into innovation and design and great storytelling, and it's just worked fantastic like this. We're hoping that nothing that we have at Raindance seems exclusive. We think that anyone who walks up on a Monday or Tuesday or Wednesday night and walk up at 6 or 7 or 8 o'clock at night, and let's look at the films playing, and you may pick the art house thriller from Kyrgyzstan, or you may pick the documentary from Brazil, or you may pick the UK feature you've never heard of, and I guarantee you that when you walk out of that, you may not like the movie, it may not be your personal taste, but I guarantee you, you will have seen a movie. These are films nothing like Hollywood. They're incredibly entertaining. They're made by deeply passionate people, filmmakers, who mainly attend the film festival, and they're right there so you can talk to them about the movie afterwards. So it's a great way to, I don't know, see stuff. You can look at our lineup at raindancefestival.org. You can get a pass for the whole damn thing. Or you can buy individual day passes or tickets from our website, raindancefestival.org.